So one way of doing this is just compare that distribution to the distributions of the word of the images that you know, and you can do it as say like a scalar dot product, right? So this histogram, if you normalize it to one, you can think of it as a normalized vector, and I compare a unit vector. I can compare unit vectors, for example, by taking dot product and finding nearest neighbor. So that's illustrated here. So I have some example d sub j, and I've got some query q. And I want to compare them. And so here are my two histograms. So my histogram here is 1814. My histogram over here is 5110. So remember, it's the same set of words, right? We're just going to say for all the words in English, what's the histogram? For all the words in my collection, what's the histogram? And I'm just going to compare, say, a similarity. So here's one example of where I take the dot product between the D and Q, divide by the length, and that's essentially giving me a similarity between them. And this is just written out for I equal 1 to V, where the idea is that you have V number of words. And again, we didn't talk about exactly how you decided what V should be. That's sort of part of the art of doing this work. So that's essentially doing a nearest neighbor lookup, right? Given some input, nearest neighbor, all right?